Learning how to be a dungeon master is a lot like going on a quest. You start at level 1, you pick up your standard starting equipment, you find a map, and you follow the path to your goal. You gotta study your spellbook and practice your weapon and slay a few lions and tigers and owlbears, but with hard work, perseverance, and something about bootstraps, you gain enough experience points to level up. And I guess that's how it works for a lot of people, but that is not how it worked for me. Thing is, I have ADHD, or Attention Deficit Hyperactivity Disorder for people who hate acronyms. And when you got ADHD, almost everything is just a little harder. I was on the same quest as everyone else, but instead of the standard starting equipment, my sword was made out of cardboard, the map was just some lines sketched on a cocktail napkin, and the owlbears were more like three liches in a trench coat. Also, the sword was cursed. Now, ADHD symptoms manifest differently in different people and at different levels of severity, so no two people are exactly alike. But generally speaking, we don't think in a straight line. We don't just see the path to our goal, we can see the whole continent, and every tree, village, and river along the way. And when you're staring at this vast continent of information and ideas and opinions, it's hard to tell what matters and what doesn't. It's easy to get overwhelmed, and we can very quickly lose the path and get lost in the wilderness. And finding that path again isn't just frustrating, it's exhausting. When I went looking for help, I found the same advice I've heard my whole life about everything. You aren't trying hard enough, or that's just how it is for everyone. I could see the same look on their face that my 12th grade history teacher, Mr. B, had when he told me, "You're very smart, Marmot, but very lazy." On the one hand, sure, I can be lazy. But on the other hand, Mr. B only had 4 fingers. He never told anybody the same story about it. It haunts me. But ADHD is not laziness. I got all this energy running through me, but I can't command it to go where I want it to. What I need is help. So that's why I'm here. Because I got there. I found this right equipment, I made a map, and I found my own way to be a dungeon master. And while I didn't exactly become the ultimate DM, I did become the ADHDM. And if that's something you want too, I want to help you get there. So I can't show you the one true way to become a DM. After years of searching, I'm pretty sure it doesn't exist. What I can do is give you ways to succeed on your own terms. Not just once, but over what I hope will be your long and happy career as a game master. If you've never touched a D20 in your life, these videos can take you from what's a D20 all the way to successfully running your first one-shot. For those of you already running games, I can make it easier. Make it less of a struggle to create good encounters and prep and remember what the hell you named that NPC. You know, make it so we spend all that energy having fun at the table instead. I can't promise you my weapon will be your weapon. You may end up preferring an axe to a bastard sword. What I can teach you is how to make any weapon you pick work for you. And that way, when you find yourself in combat and realize you left that axe back in the tavern with your shoes for some reason, old dirty bastard sword will always be there for you. Look, I'm not the all-knowing Marmot. Yet. I'm just an unusually large planeswalking ground squirrel who found a way to succeed. These videos are a lot less about me delivering knowledge from on high and a lot more about gathering other people like me together. There are a lot of communities within the larger tabletop gaming hobby, but those spaces don't always accommodate people who think and identify differently. We face unique struggles, but those struggles are shared by many other people like me and like you. You're not alone. We're a community waiting to happen. We're just 10 minutes late because we left our keys at home. So why not start right now? Tell me how ADHD affects your gaming. What are the challenges you face, and what would help you overcome them? Let me know in the comments or on Twitter, which I swear I'll start using maybe. While I am legally obligated to ask you to push the like and subscribe buttons, it truly is the best way to tell me you want me to keep going. And if you really want to fill my teacup, toss me a few bucks at the link below. Thanks for spending time with me. Don't forget to drink water. I'll see you again soon. And unclench your jaw. Yeah.